Welcome to The Frenzy. I'm Amy Zimmer. Well, we've reached the final Friday night of October, and while Saturday is Halloween, there certainly were some tricks and treats when it comes to high school football tonight. Our featured matchup on The Frenzy tonight pits longtime rivals colliding out in Pooler. The 42nd meeting between the Calvary Day Cavaliers and the Savannah Christian Raiders. The Raiders have won the past three meetings and look to keep their win streak going against the Cavs. First quarter, Calvary Day freshman quarterback Jake Merklinger in trouble. Raiders Cameron Powell with the big quarterback sack. Raiders setting the tone early. Raiders quarterback Spencer Robichaux out to wide receiver George Futch. Check out this catch. Able to stay on his feet. Gets the Raiders a nice gain. Calvary Day's defense steps up big. WJCL Big 22 member Futures Lewis II plows down Robichaux. Momentum now on Calvary Day's side. Merklinger with time. Connects with wide receiver Cameron Selders as seconds run out in the first quarter. Start of the second quarter now. Same drive. Cavs running back Greg Daniel takes it to the house. Daniel with the first touchdown of the night. Calvary Day up 7-0. And that score would be the score at the halftime. However, Savannah Christian comes alive in the second half. The Raiders defeat Calvary Day 21-14. The Savannah Country Day Hornets hosting the undefeated Aquinas Fighting Irish. Second half, Country Day up 14-7. Aquinas quarterback James Schragel with the keeper runs for a big gain. This time, Schragel again with another keeper. Puts his team on his back. Takes it all the way in for the touchdown. Aquinas fans on their feet. Momentum is high for that team with the big touchdown. Savannah Country Day quarterback looking to respond. Barry Kleinpeter here connects with David Glifflin, but comes up short. Aquinas now with the ball. James Schragel tosses the ball to Darius Stonefer. He's on his feet, able to stay up, gets the big gain. This time, the ball goes out to RJ Edwards, and he again breaks free for another big gain. This time, the ball going to Darius Stonefer, and he plows himself some more and just inching their way to the end zone. The quarterback keeper this time, and it's good for the touchdown. Hornets would go on, though, and hand Aquinas its first loss of the season, 29-28 the final. Well, after spending the better part of the season on the road, the Benedictine Cadets back at home tonight. BC hosting South Effingham at Memorial Stadium. That's where our Dave Williams was. He has a recap of what happened between the Cadets and Mustangs. Dave.
Well, Amy, it must have seemed like an eternity for the Benedictine Cadets. The last time they played a home game here at Memorial Stadium, September 4th, their season opener. Since then, they played six straight games away from Savannah, including their first two losses of the season the last 2 weeks. Tonight, they welcome South Effingham to town. And Danny Britt's Cadets had a little tougher time with the Mustangs than probably most expected. They would lead 14-12 at halftime and then widen their lead to 17-12 after Nick Dillon connects on the field goal. Then on the Cadets' next possession, they will find the promised land. Holden Gurner swings it out to Justin Thomas, and he's touchdown bound, and BC was up 24-12. But South Effingham wouldn't go away with Larry Scott operating out of the quarterback position. He takes the direct snap and gets inside the Cadet 20. One play later, it was Desmond House taking the direct snap, and he finds his way to the payoff pasture. And after the PAT, South Effingham was within five at 24-19. The Cadets, though, wasted very little time responding. In fact, on their next play from scrimmage is Holden Gurner with a perfect pass to Trent Broadnax, who steps away from the one defender and coasts into the end zone. 31-19 Benedictine, and they go on to win 39-25. In Savannah, Dave Williams, WJCL 22 News.
All right, thanks so much, Dave. The Richmond Hill Wildcats hosting the Brunswick Pirates. Pirates quarterback KJ Lee passes to Tyler Sams for a nice gain. This time, Lee going with the handoff to Jacoby Hill, and he sneaks his way in. How about the diving finish into the end zone for the touchdown? Richmond Hill trying to get something going. Quarterback Tyler Coleman hands the ball to Kenyon Hunter. He breaks right and is off and running into the end zone. Brunswick responds, Lee in the air to Patrick Leggett. He tiptoes the sideline. Wildcats chase to Lee finally taken down. A huge game for the Pirates. This time, Lee throws it to Tyrese Jones in the corner of the end zone for the touchdown. Richmond Hill looking to respond now. Quarterback Tyler Coleman throws the ball into the end zone here, all the way to Christian Boggs. The touchdown is good. What a finish. Richmond Hill goes on to win 42-27, the final. Over to Statesboro, the Blue Devils taking the field at home against Bradwell Institute. That Devil defense forcing a first half turnover. They force the Bradwell fumble, and the home team is there to recover. Offense comes on the field and cashes in. Jalen McCall gets the call. When all is said and done, this run covers 60 yards and gives the Blue Devils the early advantage. However, the Statesboro offense was just getting warmed up. Later, home team goes to the air. Quarterback Ames Ratcliffe hits Ford Wills for the 23-yard touchdown. Good night for the Blue Devils. They top Bradwell in this one, 34-16, the final. Well, we are just getting started here on The Frenzy. Still to come, plenty more highlights and scores from around Southeast Georgia and the South Carolina Lowcountry. You're watching The Frenzy. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Frenzy here on WJCL 22 News at 11. Let's jump right back into the action, this time in the SKESA and the GISA. The Bethesda Academy Blazers taking on the Dorchester Academy Raiders, picking this one up in the second half. Blazers quarterback Antoine McKay with the rocket. Wide receiver Carlton Brown there for the get up and grab catch. Touchdown is good. Blazers go up 27-0. Next Blazers possession, McKay can't find an option, tries to break away. Raiders swarm for the quarterback sack. Dorchester trying to get something going now. Quarterback Brody Marchant with no chances. Brian Davis comes around for the big quarterback sack. Yeah, good luck getting past Davis on defense. He is tall. We're talking 6'7" tall. Bethesda goes on to defeat Dorchester 37-3, the final. The St. Andrews Lions hosting the Trinity Christian Crusaders. Lions look like they would get something going right out of the gate. Anthony Kosilka makes the nice kickoff return to Trinity territory. However, couldn't capitalize. On their next possession, it's going to be Connor Dodge. He's plowing his way through, goes up the middle and takes it down to the Trinity Christian 34-yard line. They would move down into field goal territory. The Crusaders go for it. And the block and the try in the game remains scoreless. The Lions defense went on to keep it scoreless. Dodge on the defensive side of the ball now here with a nice open field tackle off the short pass. Not a single touchdown in this ball game. All about the defense. St. Andrews defeats Trinity Christian 3-0, the final. The Hilton Head Christian Academy Eagles were looking to finish the regular season undefeated as they hosted Hilton Head Prep. The Eagles got lucky early as Tommy Stauffer botches the punt. Eagles would take over. While it is not Halloween just quite yet, magic was in the air. J.P. Peduzzi airs out the throw, finding his buddy Jace Blackshear in the end zone. How about that big touchdown? Eagles go up 7. Jace Blackshear not done this time. He looks like Michael Vick as he makes the Dolphins look like fish out of the water, picking up the big first down. Then Blackshear would find Jackson Bulldog Lanier, who makes his way to the end zone, securing the bag. Eagles take this one and finish off the season undefeated. The legend Mark Clifford looking to lead the Buford Academy Eagles to victory. They visited JP2. However, the Golden Warriors came to play. Jeremiah Young able to pick up the first down. A couple plays later, Young finds Malone Kennard Hussinger for the touchdown. JP2 up 26-24 with under 5 to play. The Eagles not backing down. Jayshon Lawson finds open real estate, takes it to the 10-yard line. The senior quarterback, Braden Dineen, would keep it and head to the end zone and gets the touchdown. Buford Academy would go up 30-24 with about a minute remaining. The Golden Warriors would have to pull out the tricks as Jeremiah Young tosses it to Mark Knight. And this game would go on with under 20 seconds remaining. The final, 31-30 for the Golden Warriors. That's going to do it for this week's Frenzy. Have a great night.